I want to discuss about art. It's not art, it's ART. It is a traumatic restorative treatment. Now let's see what it is. A traumatic restorative treatment is a procedure based on removing caries tooth tissues using hand instruments alone and restoring the cavity with an adhesive restorative material. Here we are not using any complex equipment or any complex cavity design. Here we are just using a hand instrument and remove the caries tooth tissues and restore it with EAC. Okay. It's a very simple technique. ART is a procedure based on removing caries tissues using hand instruments alone and restoring the cavity with an adhesive restorative material. At present, the restorative material is glass ionoma cement. ART was developed in the mid-1980s in Tanzania. Okay, it is developed in Tanzania and it is adopted by WHO, which is on April 8, 1994. So why it is used or what are the indications of ART? Here, done where there is no power supply to run the motor, such as in very remote villages where there is no power supply, we can use this technique. In places where there is no power supply, we can use this technique. When many people had to be provide treatment, such as in refugee camps. Okay. In refugee camps and all, we can carry all such heavy instruments or equipments that is used in dentistry. There also we can use this technique. Another place is areas where it is difficult to take heavy equipments due to natural constraints. If there is flooding or earthquake in places like that, you can use this technique. Coming to contraindications, if the tooth is involved with any pulpal lesions, you can't use this technique. Like if there is any abscess of fistula, presence of a clinical pulp exposure, teeth with chronic inflammation of the pulp, and obvious caries cavity but is not accessible to hand instruments. So these are the contraindications. Coming to advantages, it is easily available and relatively inexpensive hand instruments are used. I'm going to discuss about the instruments that we're going to use. All are very inexpensive and is easily available in industry. And it's a biologically friendly approach. It is a painless procedure. Here, we are removing only the infected dentin, not the affected dentin. So infected dentin, removing infected dentin is a painless procedure. So it's a painless procedure and a straightforward and simple infection control procedure. It is chemically adhesive glass ionoma cements are used. So we don't need to follow any straightforward cavity preparation techniques. So it is chemically adhesive glass ionoma cements are used. Fluoride, that is from the glass ionoma, which prevents secondary caries. Combination of preventive and curative treatment. Low cost, it's a low cost procedure. ART involves removal of only decalcified tooth tissues, which result in relatively small cavity and conserves sound tooth tissues as much as possible. It enables to oral health workers to reach people who otherwise never receive any oral health services. Repairing of defect in the restoration can be easily done. So it's a GIC, it is basically GIC, so repairing can be easily done in such procedures. So limitations, long-term survival rate is low. As I said, we are not following any cavity preparation technique or any isolation technique, any complex isolation technique. So the long-term survival rate is low. It's just temporary adjustment. The use is limited to small and medium size one surface lesion. As I said, if it is involved to pulp or if it is involved to deep dentin where deep caries management is required, you can't use this technique. So it uses limited to small and medium size one surface lesion. The possibility of hand fatigue from the use of hand instruments over a long period of time. If you are using this technique for a long period of time, we are not using any air rotor or something like that. We are just using hand instruments and we are forcefully removing the caries tooth tissue. So chance of hand fatigue is very high. Hand mixing may procedure a relatively unstandardized mix of glass ionomas. We all know if we mix using our hand, we will get a unstandardized mixed of glass ionoma cement. Fundamental principles of cavity preparations are not followed here. Okay, coming to principles of IRDTs, the principle is very simple, only have two principle. I already mentioned that removal of carriers to structure using hand instrument only and restoring the cavity with the restorative material that stick to the tooth. So these are the principle, removing carriers to structure using hand instruments only. That is first principle. And second principle is restoring the cavity with the restorative material that stick to the tooth. Now let's see what are the instruments that we use. It's a very common instruments, very cheap instruments for basic instruments like mouth mirror, explorer, tweezer. So this is a must, mouth mirror, explorer and tweezer. Another one is a spooner squatter. This is for removing the caries. We have two types of smaller spooner squatter. One is small, used for removal of soft dentin, and another one is large, used for packing filling material under enamel and for the removal of excess filling material. No explanation needed. Another one is plastic filling instrument or plastic instrument used for applying the GIC and for shaping the restoration. Enamel access cutter. This is another instrument that is used in IRT, developed to access small cavities where the blade of the enamel hatchet might be too large. Enamel access cutter. This is a must in IRT and a carver, mixing spatula, spatula for mixing the GIC. Now we need some material also, that is cotton rolls. This is for isolation. Cotton wool pellet, that is also for isolation. Petroleum jelly, we need to apply after placement of GIC. Plastic strips is needed and wedges is also needed. So these are the materials that we used in ARP. Coming to procedures of procedure for achromatic restorative treatment. First, the tooth is isolated with cotton roll. Okay, we are just isolated using a cotton roll. The tooth surface to be treated is cleaned with a wet cotton pellet, just clean using a wet cotton pellet, and the entrance of the lesion is slightly widened by hand instruments you remove or gross over any unsupported enamel. Just widen the cavity. The dental caries is removed by using either the small or medium size spoon shaped excavator. Just remove the cavity, dental caries using a spoon excavator. If necessary, provide pulpal protection by calcium hydroxide paste. If the caries is deep, you can use a calcium hydroxide paste also. The cavity surface along with occlusal margins are cleaned. Condition the cavity and occlusal surface using a drop of dentin conditioner on a cotton wool pellet and rub both the cavity and the occlusal surface for 0 to 5 seconds. Now mixing the GIC. So mix it using the manufacturer's instructions. As a general rule, place a small spoonful of powder on the glass slab for a mixing pad. Just place a spoonful of GIC. Use the spatula to divide the powder into two equal portions. Then dispense a drop of liquid next to the powder. Divide the powder into two equal sections and dispense a drop of liquid next to the powder. Pour the liquid bottle horizontal for the movement of allow air to escape. You can see in the picture, first place the bottle in a horizontal position so that the air will escape. Move to a vertical position and allow one drop of liquid to fall on to the slab. This is first separate the liquid with spatula over a surface about 1.5 centimeters. Start mixing by adding 1/2 of the powder into liquid using the spatula. Roll the powder into the liquid, gently wetting the particle without spreading them around the slab. As soon as all the powder particles are wetted, the second portion is folded into the mix. Now mix firmly while keeping the mass together. The mixing should be completed within 20 to 30 seconds depending on the brand of glass ionomer used. The mixed glass ionomer is inserted into the cavity and slightly overfilled. It should be slightly overfilled. A gloved finger, which is smeared with petroleum jelly, is pressed on top of the entire occlusal surface and slight pressure is applied. The bite is checked. Excess material is removed with a sharp carver. The bite is rechecked and all high points are removed. The filling is covered by a petroleum jelly once again or varnish may be applied. The patient is instructed not to bite with the tooth for at least an hour. So this is all about IRP. Thank you.